Well, if it's not clear to everyone, Washington, D.C. has become an unmitigated disaster. Now, we are witnessing in real time a republic losing its tether to the basic tenets that have made America the envy of the world. And anybody who believes that Joe Biden is the white knight preordained to save us from ourselves either isn't paying attention or is woefully ignorant of history. So, yes, we've seen a flurry of activity, one executive order after the next, the bread and circuses of politics, the comfort food for the masses designed to convince the uninformed that help is just around the corner. But right now, let's be very clear. The theater of American politics is distracting us from the politics that are destroying America. Now, Nancy Pelosi and her colleagues on the left, they've flooded the airways with their partners in division, the mainstream media, to declare that they don't feel safe in the presence of their other colleagues. She and others have effectively labeled their Republican fellow colleagues en masse an untrustworthy, homicidally inclined, traitorous gang, with the Speaker of the House literally uttering the phrase, "The enemy is in the House." Well, AOC and the squad have also essentially declared that the entirety of the conservative movement is defined by QAnon and that any and all policies derived by Republicans is the work of white supremacy. So let me be clear. Let's have a little news for these children of American privilege masquerading as lawmakers on a mission for justice and equality for all. When you treat half of America as your enemy, or worse, evil incarnate, you shouldn't be surprised when their response is combative. Now, let me be clear. Congress, by no means, should ever be used as a staging ground for violence. But it was never designed to be a safe space free from verbal or ideological conflict. The people who raised their hand to serve have volunteered to ask the unasked question and to confront society's most uncomfortable truth, whether they realize it or not. The job of Congress is to find the compromise society needs, even when the people of society can't stomach the work required to come together. And yet, in this moment, the tool that was designed to keep America bound together has become the chief wedge that is driving Americans further and further apart. This constant desire to cancel everything and everyone we don't agree with is a cancer consuming the goodwill to govern and the trust necessary to preserve a functioning society. And now that cancer has metastasized and spread from our public life to infect the safeguards of our political governance. You cannot preserve the Constitution that protects all Americans by violating that Constitution to mete out political retribution. And yet we have seen from this continued push for the impeachment of President Trump to now calls to expel a duly elected member of Congress that the very norms our leaders claim they love are simply matters of political expediency. The job of the 535 members that make up the U.S. Senate and U.S. House of Representatives is not to tell us who we have the right to elect. It is their job to find a way to work together with the duly elected leaders the people have chosen to fulfill the ambitions of a grateful nation. And with joblessness run amok, with despair spiraling out of control, with special interests trying to place their thumb on the scale and crush the common man, as we witnessed this week on Wall Street, if these politicians don't get it together soon and very soon, we won't have a republic left to save. Because today, it may be Trump or some other politician you despise, but back in 1967, it was Adam Clayton Powell Jr., a black Democrat from Harlem, who Congress refused to seat for their own personal political grievances. And if we end up in a place where Congress decides who represents the American people, then the people of America will no longer have a voice and will be stuck in an unmitigated disaster that no one ever wants to revisit.